Welcome, dear students. Today we discuss limit point on a set, which is called also accumulation point, condition point. We will discuss the definition of limit points and some characteristics on limit points. Some characteristics or properties of limit points of the set have already been written for saving our time. So you are advised not to follow this right now. We will discuss in their respective terms. So just let's start on limit points. First of all, we have to understand what is limit points. That is, we are trying to define limit points. The definition of limit points, definition of limit point is a number x0, which is a real number, is said to be a limit point of a set S, which is subset of real number also, if every neighborhood of X naught contains infinitely many points of S. The definition is a real number x0 is said to be limit point of S, which is subset of R, if every neighborhood of X naught contains infinitely many points of S. In other words, x0 belongs to R is said to be a limit point of S, which is subset of R, if every neighborhood of X naught contains at least one point of S other than X naught. The second definition is such, any real number X naught is said to be limit point of a set S, which is subset of R, if every neighborhood of X naught contains at least one point of S other than X naught. That is, in mathematically we can say that, or we can form an operation which is X naught minus epsilon 2 X naught plus epsilon intersect with the set S other than X naught will be non-empty. If this mathematical operation is non-empty, then we can say that X naught is a limit point of set S. I say again, X naught minus epsilon to X naught plus epsilon intersect with the set S except X naught will be non-empty. Then X naught will be called the limit point of S. Now we can take an example on limit points. Here we take an example on limit points of a set. Suppose we have a set in example 1, S, which contains finite numbers 1, 2, and 3. That is, this example again is a finite set. Now we will have to find out the limit point of this set. We draw a real line and plot this number on their line. Suppose this points indicates 1, this points 2, this points 3. Now we check whether this point are limit point of this set or any other real number can be possible limit point of this set. We take this number 2. Let x0 is a number which indicates 2. Let x0 be a real number which is 2 included in this set. Now we consider a neighborhood around 2 such which is x0 minus epsilon 2, x0 plus epsilon. And intersect with this set S except x0. Then we see what will be happened. This implies that if we can take epsilon equal to 0.1, this implies 2 minus 0.1, 2, 2 plus 0.1, intersect with S, that is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, minus x0, that is 2. This indicated by x0, x0 equal to 2, minus 2. This implies that 2 minus 0.1, that is 1.9. 2.1, intersect with this says 1, 2, 3, minus 2, that is 1. So this result goes to what we will see. The intersection of this two set is nothing. That is, it is an empty set. Since it is an empty set, we can say that none of real number is limit point of this set. So we can say that any finite set has no limiting point. Characteristics, finite set have no limiting points. So dear students, saw that set of finite number, that is finite set, have no limiting point. That's because it does not follow the definition of limiting points. We see here, if this set is infinite set, then it has also no limit point. So we can say that the set of a natural number, set of integers, and set of whole numbers have no limit point. So this characteristic we have got. N, Z, W, the natural number, integers, whole numbers have no limit points. A similar thing with the finite set. Now we consider another example, example number 2. We are going to find out the limit point of a set with an example. Let example 2, S is a closed interval from A to B. We are going to find out the limiting point or limiting points of this set. Similarly, we can draw a real line and plot this interval on this real line, closed interval A to B, and we denote this interval by S. Now we take a number from this interval, that is from its interior position. Suppose it is an arbitrary number X naught which lies between A and B. Now we have to check x0 can be limit point of S or not. So we take an integral or neighborhood around x0, that is x0 minus epsilon 2 x0 plus epsilon, and then intersect this with the set S except the number x0. So x0 minus epsilon 2 x0 plus epsilon intersect with the set S minus x0. We see that this function follows that this interval contains infinite number of point which belongs to this closed interval, as because at the right position of x naught there are many numbers which lies in this closed interval. Also, in the left side there are many numbers which lies in this closed interval. Now, if we delete x naught, then it contains infinite number of points which belong to this closed interval. So we can say that this operation indicates a non-empty set equal to non-empty set. So since this operation is a non-empty set, so by definition we can say that x0 is a limiting point of S. So x0 is a limiting point of S. If we consider any number in between A and B, then we will see that it will be a limiting point of S. Now we observe the limiting point at boundary point A. If we take this point as x1 equal to A, then our new interval x1 minus epsilon 2 x1 plus epsilon intersect with S minus x1, it will be a set which is also non-empty, as because we draw a neighborhood around A, we have got a such type of interval, and we clearly see here half of this interval included in this A2B interval, and these points are lies on this interval, but this point are not lie on this interval. Whether this point are not belong to this interval, then we can say that since here are many points which belong to this interval, so this operation will be non-empty. That is why we can also say that x1 is a neighborhood of this set. So x1 is also neighborhood of S. Dear students, what can we see here? We see here that any real number in between A and B, including A and B, are the limit point of this set, S. So we can easily say that the limit point of this closed interval is itself. Therefore, the limiting point of S equal to closed interval A to B. Limiting point of S equal to A to B is itself. So a set itself can be a limiting point of this set. Now, if we consider this interval, that is example number 3, as an open interval, which does not include the point boundary point A and B. So, by similar discussion, we can say that the limiting point of this interval will be whole closed set from A to B. That's because all interior points will be the limiting point of this point. And at boundary point, if we draw a neighborhood, then it contains many numbers which are included in this open interval. So, the limiting point of S equal open interval AP, which is also closed interval AP. And these words are applicable for open closed interval and also for closed open interval. So from here we have got another characteristics. Limit points of closed interval AB, open interval AB, open closed interval AB, and closed open interval, all these limit points are closed interval AB. We have got another characteristics on limit points of a set. And from this discussion, we also have got another point that limit point of a set may lie on this set or boundary points or outside of this interval or open interval. So this characteristics is true that limit points of a set S may or may not belong to S. That is, limit pair can be included in respective set or may not include in this respective set. Outside of the set can be a limit point. It is clear from our discussion. So one is discussed. Now we take another example which has only one limiting box. And this example could be a beautiful example, example 4. Let S equal a set 1 by n and belongs to set of natural number. So if we write this set in list method, we have got, if we put 1, 2, 3, 4, n, we got 1 by 1, that is 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, and so on. And just shouldn't follow here, the number goes to 0. Exactly not 0. If we take last value for 10, then it will approaches to 0. So this set contains the elements which lies between 0 and 1. It does not contain 0 but approaches to 0. If we check 0 is limit point or not of this set, then we can take the value of x0 equal to 0. Now the example x0 minus epsilon to x0 plus epsilon, let epsilon equal 0.1 and x0 equal to here 0. So this label is 0 minus 0.1 to 0 plus 0.2. That is minus 0.1 to 0.1. And if we intersect with the set S, intersect with the set S, except the number 0, x0, we get intersect S minus 0. And we see that intersection of minus 0.1 to 0.1 with S minus 0, which is also contain a number. 0 lies on this interval, but 0 is not, 0 is not, 0 is not here. We see that 0 lies on this interval, but 0 is not here. But the intersection of these two sets contains many numbers which lie on this set. That's because last number or boundary numbers are very much close to 0. So we can say that the intersection of this set is non-empty. It contains many numbers, minus 0.1, which are included in this set. So this is a non-empty set. So easily we can say that the limit point of S equal to 0. Limit point of S equal to 0. So here we see that a set has only one limit point. In the previous example, we saw that many numbers can be limiting point of a set. So we can easily say that this characteristic is true. A set may have no limit points, or finite set or infinite set which numbers are discrete, that is n, z, w, or may have finite number of limit points, that is this set contains only one limit point, which is 0, or may have an infinite number of limit points, which we saw in the previous example. So we can say that a set may have no limiting points, or may have finite number of limiting points, or may have an infinite number of limit points. Now we are going to check the limit point of set of real number. Example 4. Example 5, sorry, limit point of real number. We draw a real line, and from this we choose a real number x naught, which is a real number. If we draw a neighborhood around this x naught, it contains infinite number of real numbers. If we exclude x0 from here, so we see that there are infinite number of real numbers which are included in a set of real numbers. So here we can say that if we intersect with the set of real numbers except x naught, which is a real number, so the intersection result is non-empty. Therefore, the limit point of set of real number is itself, that is, limiting point of real number is set of real numbers. This properties is have the limit points of real number equal to real number. All the real numbers can be called limiting point the set of real numbers. Now we are going to work on set of rational number and irrational number. We know that the set of rational number and irrational numbers both are not open as well as not closed. But we will see what happens in here. Example 6, a set of rational number Q and set of rational number and irrational number Q complements. If we take a point from rational number, suppose x not equal to 1, which is a rational number. Now, if we make an interval or neighborhood around x around 1, x naught minus epsilon 2, x naught plus epsilon, this indicates that this interval will be 1 minus epsilon 2, 1 plus epsilon. And we very much clear that this interval contains infinite number of rational number as well as infinite number of irrational number. So we can say that 1 is limiting point of rational number Q as well as 1 is also limit point of irrational number Q complement. As because this interval contains infinite number of rational number as well as irrational number. That is why 1 is called limiting point of rational number and limiting point of irrational number. Again, if we take an irrational number from set of irrational number that is x1 equal to root. Now, if we make an interval or neighborhood x1 minus epsilon 2 x1 plus epsilon, this is similar to this interval. Root 2 minus epsilon, root 2 minus epsilon to root 2 plus epsilon, it also contains infinite number of rational number and irrational number. So we can say that root 2 is a limiting point of set of irrational number as well as root 2 is a limiting point of set of rational number Q. That is why we can be able to prove that any real number will be limiting point of the set of rational number as well as the set of irrational number. That is why we can say that the limiting point of rational number and limiting point of irrational number is the set of real numbers. All real numbers can be treated limiting point of rational number as well as irrational number. That is why there are another characteristics. Q and Q complement, that is rational and irrational number, has infinite number of limiting points. And these points are the set of real numbers. So, dear students, we have discussed all the properties on limiting points. So, I would like to conclude my today's session here. If you feel problem to understand this discussion, so you are advised to view the video by reviewing again and again. And also, you can pause the video and take a screenshot. So that you will read the script in future and easily can understand the discussion. Thank you very much.